I'm a lighthouse.
He's pounded down, loaded up and trucking. Are we gonna do what they say can't be done? We've got a long way to go and a short time to get there. I'm eastbound just like no bandit run. Keep your foot hard on the pedal, son, never mind them brakes. Let it all hang out, cause we got a run to make. The boys are thirsty in Atlanta, and there's beer in Texarkana, and we'll bring it back no matter what it takes. Eastbound and down, loaded up and trucking. Are we gonna do what they say can't be done? We've got a long way to go and a short time to get there. I'm eastbound just watch your band.
Good day, Lord.
Lennox, what brings you here?
Many things. Well, my former speeches have but hit your thoughts, which can interpret farther. Only I say things have been strangely born. The gracious Duncan was pitied of me. Mary, for he was dead, and the right valiant bank will walk too late, whom you may say, if it please you, Fleance killed. For Fleance fled. Men must not walk too late who cannot thought how monstrous it was for Malcolm and for Donald Bane to kill their gracious father. Damn that. How did it not grieve Macbeth? That 'twere to kill a father, so should flames. But peace, far from broad words, because he failed. His presence at the tyrant's feast, I hear Macduff lives in disgrace. Sir, can you tell where he bestows himself?
The son of Duncan, from whom the tyrant holds due of birth, lives in English court and is revised of most pious Edward with such grace, that the malevolence of fortune nothing take from his high respect. There Macduff is going to pray the holy king upon his aid, to wake Northumberland and warlike Silward, that by the help of these, with him above to ratify the work, we may again give to our tables meat, sleep, to our knights, free of our feasts and banquets bloody night, do faithful homage and receive free honors, all which we pine for now, and this report hath no aspiration the king that he prepares for some attempt of war.
Sent he to Macduff?
He did, with absolute sir, not I. And cloudy messenger turns his back. He hums, and who should say, you rue the time, and talk you with the answer?
That well might advise him to caution of what distance his wisdom can provide. Some holy angel fly to the court of England and unfold his message ere he come, that a swift blessing may soon return to our suffering country under a hand accursed.
I'll send my prayers with him. Finn.
Where are they? Gone? Let this pernicious hour stand I accursed to the calendar. Come in without there.
What's your grace's will?
Saw you the weird sisters?
No, my lord.
Came they not by you?
No, indeed, my lord.
Infected be the air whereon they ride, and damn those that trust them. I did hear horses gallop by. Who was it that came by?
'Tis two or three, my lord, that brings you word that Macduff has fled to England.
England?
Ah, my good lord.
Time thou anticipates my dreaded exploits. The fightly purpose is never overlook, unless the deed go with it from this moment. The very firstings of my heart shall be to crown my thoughts with acts, the thought and done. The castle of Macduff I will surprise, seize upon Fife, and give it to the edge of the sword. His wife, his babes, and all unfortunate souls that trace him in the line. No boasting like a fool, this deed I'll do before this purpose cool. But no more sights. What are these gentlemen? Come, bring me to where they are. Robert Stacy here, and boy do I have the product for you. This just in. Sticks. We got all kinds of sticks and stuff. We've got short sticks for poking things that are close by. We've got medium sticks for poking things that are slightly farther away. And we have the long stick for poking those hard to reach places. Also, long sticks act as a tree seed. Plant one of these babies in your front yard to show your neighbors what a true nature buff you really are. But wait, there's more. Act now and we'll throw in a free look. Only for 20 easy payments of $5. Act now while before the prices go through the roof.
Action.
Hark.
Egg.
Oh, in 1995.
Bring me no more reports. Let them fly all till Burnham would remove to Dunsinane. And I cannot taint with fear. What's the boy Malcolm? Is he not born of a woman? The spirits that know all mortal consequences have pronounced me thus. Fear not, Macbeth. No man that's born of a woman shall ever have power upon thee. Then fly, false thanes, and mingle with the English epicures. The mind I sway, and the heart I bear shall never sag nor shake with fear.
Excuse me, sir.
The devil damn thee black, thou cream-faced wound. Where goest thou that geese look?
There is 10,000.
Geese villain?
Soldiers, sir.
Thy face over red thy fear, thou lily-livered boy. What soldier's patch? Theft of thy soul. Those linen cheeks of thine are counselors to fear. What soldier's way, face?
The English force, so please you.
Thy face hence. Satan! I'm sick at heart. When I behold Satan, I say, this push will cheer me ever. Deceit me now. I've lived long enough. My way of life had fallen into the scene. The yellow leaf, that which should accompany old age. This honor, love, obedience, troops of friends must not have to look but in their stand. Curses! Not loud, but deep, mouth honor, breath which the poor heart would fain deny and dare not. Satan!
What's your gracious pleasure?
What news more?
All's confirmed, my lord, which is reported.
I'll fight till from my bones my flesh be hacked. Give me my armor.
'Tis not needed yet.
I'll put it on, send out more horses, scour the countryside, hang those that talk of fear. Give me mine armor. How's the patient, doctor?
Not so sick, my lord, as she is covered with thick common fancies that keep her from her rest.
Cure her of that. Canst thou not, minister of mine diseased? Pluck from the memory of the convented sorrow. Raise out the written troubles of the brain, and with some sweet, ambitious antidote, cleanse the stuffed basement of that perilous stuff, which weighs out upon the heart.
Therein the patient, the minister to himself.
Throw physics to the dogs. I'll none of it. Come, give me my staff.
Capital idea, old sport.
Indeed it is.
I say.
Doctor, the thanes fly from me. Come on, dispatch. If thou couldst, doctor, can't the water of my land find her disease and purge it to a sound and pristine health? I would applaud thee to the very echo. That should applaud again. Pull it off, I say. What rhubarb, senna, or what purgative drug would scout these English hence? Hearest thou of them?
Aye, my good lord, your royal preparation makes us hear something.
Bring it after me. I will not be afraid of death and bane till Burnham Wood come to Dunsinane.
Were I from Dunsinane, away and clear. Profit again should hardly draw me here.
Oh, hi there. Are you ready for the buy of a lifetime? Are you ready to hear songs such as Help, I'm on fire. Songs from the Wild West. And songs such as Stairway to Heaven. You can have all these songs and more on my demo CD. So bust out the credit cards and start paying my bills, because this can be all yours for just 200 easy payments of $19.95.
No way! Why should I play the Roman fool and die on my own sword? Whilst I see lives, the gashes do better upon them!
Turn, hellhound, turn!
Of all men else I have avoided thee, but get thee back. My soul is much too charged, but with blood of thine already.
I have no words, my voice is in my sword. Thou bloodiest villain, my terms can give thee out.
Thou losest labor, as easy mayest thou the entrenched air with thy keen sword and press as make me bleed. Let fall thy blade on invulnerable quest. I bear a charmed life which must not yield to one.
Despair thy charm, and let the angel whom still hast served tell thee Macduff was from his mother's womb untimely ripped.
Accursed be the tongue that tells me so, for hath cowed my better part of man, and be these struggling fiends no more believe that patterlith us in double sense, that keep the word of promise to our ear, and break it to our hope.
And yield thy coward, and live to be the show, and gaze, O thy time, we have thee as our razor monsters are painted on a pole and unwit. Here may you see the tyrant.
I will not yield to kiss the ground before young Malcolm's feet, and to be baited with the rabble's curse. Though Burnham Wood be come to Dunsinane, and thou oppose being no woman born, yet I will try the last before my body. I throw my warlike shield. Lay on, Macduff, and be damned him who first cries, hold enough! Hey, look over there!
Oh man, Macbeth!
Sir, have you seen Macbeth?
Wait a minute.
yourself, huh?
Rising up, back on the street.
Voices.
Took my time, took my chances.
When recording.
Hey, Robert Space here. Boy, do I got the product for you. This just in. Sticks. We all kind of sticks here. We got short sticks.
Shut up.
People with English epicures. My best way. All right, there's your now. You're sick.
I don't know how to zoom, so it'll probably stick.
Hold still.
Alright. And action. Without chips in the back.
Oh god!
Why, yeah.
Dad? Is that you? It's been so long!
Oh no!
I didn't mean to tell him to
do it. Stains fly from me. Come, sir. Dispatch. If thou couldst, doctor, cast the water of my land, find me her disease and purge it to a sound.
I'm sorry.